group. It was probably on this Lutz that it happened.
Rod, I think you've got some further information for us.
Well, I just talked to a young fellow who looks like his Olympic dreams are shattered, but he actually had a smile. The whole front of his skate, there is not a rivet left. The whole front part of it, he looks like he's lost about four or five of them. He says he's going to go get it repaired, and he is going to be able to skate again, apparently. So that's good news for him. Debbie, Brian?
Petrenko is now taking the ice. And the announcer is making it known to the building that once Victor has skated and if Marcus Hurnitz has repaired his skate blade, he will come and re-skate the entire program.
Well, this has got to be a real test for Victor, though.
So with a skater having had some skate problems prior to Victor, now, the thing that probably is in Victor's head is, are there screws on the ice? Waiting for his name to be called, Victor Petrenko from Russia, from where is Victor from?
He's from the Ukraine now, that's right. And now for the first time ever, he's skating for the Ukraine.
And this is a really important moment for him. And an important moment for the young skater before Victor, Marcus Hurnitz, who lost all the screws on the front of his blade.
Victor Petrenko.
Now from the Ukraine, living in Las Vegas, the 1992 Olympic men's champion, Victor Petrenko.
His third Olympic Games, his third flag, country flag that he's competing under. He competed for the Soviet Union first, and now he's competing for Ukraine. And he competed under the Olympic flag in 1992. Important and the most difficult element in the program is a triple axel and a planned triple toe loop. Combination right off the top. Here it is. And a deduction there with the three turn in between. Problem on the triple Lutz. I can't believe it. Probably the most unpredictable event. I was expecting some greatness from these guys. Tell just one small delay in the program, with the problem with the skater before, with the blade and the screws coming out, setting off, I mean, changing his whole plan and his pattern. And it's, like I said, it was it's a real test. And boy, oh boy, I'm shocked.
I think he's shocked too.
You do these programs hundreds of times, and we've been watching him all week. He's been nailing the combination every single time, and he's been nailing the triplets. Here's the combination here. Nice height at the start. Started to lean right halfway through the jump, he started to lean.
And then where he had planned a triple toe as the second jump, had to settle for a double.
Triple S didn't get the height, not near the height that we've been seeing from him all week. This is the double axel. Still somewhat conservative after those two mistakes. I think you have to be.
Well, it's a break for a lot of the other skaters who expected Victor to be way up there. The required elements mark very conservative.
The marks for required elements, 5-0, 5-0.
The crowd is just hushed. No one can believe it.
4-8, 5-0, 5-0.
Including Victor, I'm sure.
4-7, 5-1.
And for presentation. Some nice ones there, but Brian Boitano of the U.S., the first skater of the night, is still in first place.
And the marks for presentation, 5-8, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-6, 5-7, 5-5, 5-8.
Now with having the day off in between, he's going to have to reevaluate the whole situation. Think about his focus.